Hi everybody and welcome back to the Ultimate DevOps Git course from Code to Start with Muhammad Fathi. Now we have Git installed and configured. We are ready to create our very first Git repository. So let me start by opening a terminal. You can open your favorite terminal or if you're on Windows, you can open your Git Bash. So here on a Linux subsystem, I'm gonna first make a new directory by typing the command mkdir, stands for make a directory. This directory called, for example, dev oops. You can make any directory or any name and press enter. The directory will be created. So let me go or navigate to this directory by typing the command cd. Cd stands for change directory. So after that, the directory name dev oops and press enter. You can type, for example, a few letters and press tab. It will be autocomplete and press enter. Now you are in this directory. You can type the bwd print working directory and press enter. You will see the path home Fathi and the devops folder. So let me first create a new repository. You have learned any git command. Start with the command git. After that, you will give the subcommand. So subcommand will tell git what you want to do. For example, I want to initialize a new repository by typing this subcommand init, and init stands for initialize. So this means initialize a new repository. So I'm gonna type git init and press enter. So you will see initialized empty git repository in this path home Fathi devops the dot git folder forward slash. Notice that the trailing forward slash, which imply that the dot git is actually a folder. So if I list all files and the folder in this directory, you should see a dot git folder, shouldn't we? Actually, we will not show this. So let me type the ls. So we will not show anything because in all Unix systems, all files and the folders begin with the dot r actually hidden. So let me type the ls dash a to show all files and folders, including the hidden files and the folder, and press enter. Now we will see the dot git folder. So this is our first repository. So this represents the database that will store or record all changes and the files folder in our project and or in our DevOps project. So let me go to this database or this repository by typing cd change directory to dot git and press enter. So let me type ls to list all files and the folder. You will see files and the folder here. For example, the folder will be colored blue. So this is, we have a head file, branches, folder, a config, file description, and so on. So this is our repository that will track all changes in this folder, the DevOps folder. You can see this, we have a config file to store the git information local to this repository. We have learned the configuration can be stored at three levels: the system level, this is the higher one, the system level. After that, we can a global level and the local level. All local information can stored in this file, the .config file. So let me, so in this, so we will have now a dot git repository or a dot git database. So if you gonna create a new file, so this file will be stored in this repository. If you make a change, it will be also stored here. So the dot git here represent our database. So let me go back by typing the command cd dot dot and press enter. Now we have create our first repository. If you want to need more about any git command, you can Google it or search on the Google, or you can easily here type this command, type the command you want to learn more about it. For example, git init. And after that, type dash dash help. So and press enter, you will get a lot of information about this command. For example, here the name get init create an empty get repository or initialize reinitialize an existing one. So you can read about this and by press the space to read more, and you can exit or quit by typing the Q. It will be exit. Also, you can if you wanna any help, you can get, for example, the command, for example, config, and you can type help. Or if you wanna the summary, you wanna show a summary, not a complete help, you can type --h and press enter. You will see a summary about this command like this. For example, this config file location, you can store the configuration global level or the at the system level or at the local level. So use this global config file, system config file, or use a repository config file. So this is at we now at the end of this lecture. We will see you in the next lecture. Bye.